In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you. Good morning to everyone, a very special welcome to all of you on this day of the graduation of our students and their families and friends, faculty and the school board, because you're all one in the family of God. We remember that we are sinners. We ask God's forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, may God forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the heavens. A
the time to be born, and the time to die, the time to plant, and the time to uproot, the time to kill, and the time to heal, the time to tear down, and the time to build, the time to weep, and the time to laugh, the time to mourn, and the time to dance, the time to scatter stones, and the time to gather them, the time to embrace, and the time to refrain from embracing, the time to search, and the time to give up, the time to keep, and the time to throw away, the time to tear, and the time to mend, the time to be silent, and the time to speak, the time to love, and the time to hate, the time for war, and the time for peace, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm is, "Ask not what God can do for you."
Ask not what God can do for you.
Ask not what God can do for you. He does it every day, from the first bright rays of sunlight to moonlight on the bay.
Ask not what God can do for you.
Each day is another blessing, each season a delight, for those who truly know Him and walk with His light.
Ask not what God can do for you.
His love is everlasting, His promises are true. His children know already what God can do for you.
That's not what God can do for you.
His words are inspiring, His gifts are free to all, and He is always watching, each time a sparrow falls.
That's not what God can do for you.
He's the Alpha and Omega, creator of all men. Ask not what God can do for you, believe and let Him in.
Ask not what God can do for you.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Peace and hope. Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have gained access by faith into this grace in which we now stand, and we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Not only so, but we also glory in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance, character, and character, hope. And hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit, who has been given to us. You see, at just the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though for a good person, someone might possibly dare to die. But God demonstrates His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Since we have now been justified by His blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through Him? For if, while we were God's enemies, we were reconciled to Him through the death of His Son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved through His life? The word of the Lord.
To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another one, to each according to his ability. And then he went away. He who had received the 5 talents went at once and traded with them and made 5 talents more. So also he who had 2 talents made 2 talents more. But he who received the 1 talent went and dug in the ground a hole and hid his master's money. Now, after a long time, the master of those servants came and settled accounts with them. And he who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 talents more, saying, "Master, you delivered to me 5 talents. Here, I have made 5 more. His master said to them, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of the Lord." And also he who had 2 talents came forward and said, "Master, you delivered to me dose of 2 talents. Here I have made 2 talents more." And his master said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over a little. I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master." He also who had received the 1 talent came forward, saying, "Master, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering where you scattered no seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours." But his master answered him, "You knew that I reap where I have not sown, and gather where I scattered no seed. Then you ought to have invested my money with bankers, and at my coming I should have received what was my own with interest. So take the talent from him and give it to the one who has 10 talents. For everyone who has will be given more, and he will have in abundance." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Everybody knows my name. My name is Father John McKenna, one of the parish priests here. I've been at the parish for 8 years. I've seen these young people grow into some fine, wonderful young people, and I'm very happy to be here. A proud graduate of your school, our school, class of 1965, and my mother's family, 6 children, all of them. We grew up on 59th Street, and they're proud graduates too. So. A lot of people in my family, like yours, have loved this school and grateful for the wonderful foundation we have. Our Lord Jesus, often when he had a message that he wanted to teach and he wanted people to remember, put it in the form of a story. We call these stories parables. So parables are not fairy tales. They're not bedtime stories so that kids will get quiet and go to sleep faster. They're just the opposite. They're wake-up stories. Many people in his life and many people today are spiritually asleep and need to be woken up. And Jesus would tell parables. They're stories that are built around a very powerful nucleus of truth. And that's why parables today even have an impact in our lives if we let them. One time I heard this example, might not work too well here in the city, but it says that parables are like if you have a lawn that needs to be mown, that the grass needs to be mown, and you step here and there's a rake and it comes and it knocks you in the head. That's what its purpose is, to knock us in the head. Maybe you remember, ooh, I could have had a V8. Remember that? Ooh, it's meant to wake us up. Parables are in many ways, they're like electric cables. The cable around it shields us from the the incredible power of electricity, but when it's contained, it can light up many places, and it can light up our world. And I think that's what the parables are about. A truth that we have to allow into our lives. Some people have even said that the parables were the very reason why they crucified Jesus. There was too much truth. When people recognized themselves in the parables, he was like pulling away their mask. He was revealing the hypocrisy of people. If I can give one little testimony, I know the story of the prodigal son, the parable of the prodigal son. I know it. I've read it, studied it, preached about it. But I remember one time when I heard that parable, and it was a rake that hit me in the head. Because I could never identify with the younger son who went away and squandered everything, you know, had a wonderful life, wine, women, and song, you know, everything, and spent it all. I wasn't that kind of a guy, you know. But the story says, then there was the other son who did everything right, but did it with a very small heart. It was a moment where I was like the Grinch. My heart was too small. I couldn't understand the mercy of God. And I remember went to confession, and the only thing I said to the priest was, I'm the older son. I do the right thing sometimes, but I do it with such anger or feeling myself better than others. And it was a moment of truth. So parables have that. Jesus used a parable today. Said there was a rich man who was going on a journey, and he called his servants together. All right? And he entrusted a fortune to them. The word they use is 5 talents, 2 talents, 1 talent, each one according to their ability. So he knew his servants. And talent, just at that time, was a unit of currency. It was money. But we're going to use it in the sense that you and I understand talents, which are gifts that we have received. All right? And if we do it that way, and if we think that this story is a story about us, about you, about the class, the graduating class of 2019 from our Lady Perpetual Help Catholic Academy of Brooklyn, and each one individual, it might have a great moment of truth for us. So the first case is that the master freely gives away what he has. But it's a gift, but a gift with a purpose. It's also an investment. You are our investment in a future. Okay? God has poured out into you gifts and talents and abilities and extraordinary qualities. This particular class, a very large class, your absence in our school is going to be felt very, very greatly. And so many gifts and so many talents. God gave them to you. Your parents have cultivated them in your home life and supported you. Your school and your teachers, everybody here has been trying to help you cultivate what are your gifts and talents. But are yours, but they're not yours. They came from God, and He gives them to you in trust. He entrusts them to you. And you know what? He expects something back. That's the hard part about this. Okay? When God gives gifts, He's giving them for future generations through you. That all the gifts you have received, and they are many. Many of you are academically very, very brilliant. Others have extraordinary talents of music and art and poetry and leadership and athletic abilities. All gifts. And Scripture says this about gifts: the gift you have received, give as a gift. Give it away. If you want to, Jesus says, if you want to save your life, give it away. There's a song that just goes like this: if you lose your life for my sake, if you will find it, if you want to save your life, let it go. Take up your cross, deny yourself. In Spanish, there's a song: amar es entregarse, olvidándose de sí. To love is to give yourself away, looking for other people's happiness. So your gifts are gifts and talents and treasures that God has entrusted to you, and He begs you to continue to cultivate them and to allow all the other people who are still going to be entering into your life to help you cultivate them. And this is kind of a hard parable because he's hardest on the person who was afraid, who buried his treasure. He didn't steal it, he just buried it. Okay, he didn't do anything with it. That would be, I think, the saddest thing for any graduate here, to have taken what you have received and received as gifts from your parents, your teachers, from all the people who have invested in you because they believe in you and in the impact that you can make in the future. There are people who haven't even been born yet who are going to depend on you. You're going to be the surgeons. You're going to be the political leaders. You're going to be their parents, their family. Please, please do not hide your gift or bury it. Jesus says, we don't put it by the lamp and put it under a bushel basket. We put it on a stand so that all can see it. We are proud of you and we want to put you up there on that pedestal so that your light will help all the other people in the world. Okay? I pray that all of us, when it comes our time to go home to God after a long life of giving, having given just about everything away of what we've learned, of what we've loved, given it all away, we're going to hear a wonderful welcome from Jesus. Well done. Well done, good and faithful servants. Enter into the joy of the Lord.
The response to our petitions is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our cardinals and bishops, especially Bishop DeMarzio, that the Holy Spirit will guide them with wisdom and strength to proclaim the gospel of Christ to the world in truth and in love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world and for the safety of those who seek to achieve it in our fragile world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For children everywhere, may they be blessed with good health and kind families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the most vulnerable among us, the unborn children, frail elderly, and all who depend on the love and assistance of others, that they may benefit from the compassionate care of those who follow Christ. Por los más vulnerables entre nosotros, por los no nacidos, por los ancianos y los que dependen de otros para que se beneficien de la compasión de los que siguen a Cristo. Dar respeto al Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are being called by God to serve Him in the priesthood and religiously, that they may respond with generosity, courage, and a loving heart. Por las vocaciones sacerdotales y la vida religiosa, para que respondan con generosidad, coraje y un corazón amoroso. Dar respeto al Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Our Lady of Perpetual Hope, Catholic Academy of Berkeley, that we may become a beacon of hope and light to the students, families, and communities that we serve. Por nuestra Academia de Nuestra Señora del Perpetuo Socorro de la Diócesis de Berkeley, para que seamos luz y esperanza para los estudiantes, familiares y las comunidades que servimos. Let us pray to the Lord.
those who are ill, may they be healed through God's infinite mercy. 请为病患者祈祷，求主赐他无限的慈爱，帮助病人得到痊愈。 Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially our immigrant ancestors and those who will build and sustain our community of faith, that they may find eternal happiness in the home God has prepared for them, and that they may one day be reunited with them for all eternity. 请为亡者祈祷，特别是那些以亡者的祖先以及尽力并保护我们堂区信仰的人的祈祷，望他们在天主为他们所准备的天下以找到随主的福乐，并使我们终有一天在天上团聚，享受水福。 Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us not pause as we wait our own intentions to the Lord. 现在让我们 并向天主祈求我们自己所要的恩宠。
It gave us insight into medicine. sword. We were taught that we do not have to use our fists to solve our problems, but we can change the world with the stroke of a pen. The pen. The globe. The globe is a symbol of diversity and unification, which teaches us to be respectful and embrace different cultures and traditions in this world. The globe. Language text. The language text is a wonderful symbol that helps us to appreciate poetry, the use of our imagination and creative ability. It gave us a closer look at great poet and writers, such as Emily Dickinson, William Shakespeare, Langston Hughes, and Maya Angelou. The language text. Social studies text. Our social studies text gives us the opportunity to learn about the world before our existence. It allowed us to embrace different cultures and learn from the past and what we can expect in the future. Social studies text. Math textbook. Our math textbook provides us with the tools and formulas on how to deal with everyday things, from learning how to count, creating budgets, buying video games, counting our allowance, to averaging out our grades. Math textbook.
Let us sing together our offertory song, Here I Am, Lord, found in our program.
At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly
his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. We pray as Jesus taught us, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace. Peace is my gift to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share that peace now with one another.
It is one bread, one body, found in our program.
Thank you. Comment and subscribe in 3, 2, 1.